Thank you, Fridi. Hello, colleagues. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening for some of you. I will talk about some elements on our statistical office, then the context of digital transformation, and give some background information on national data ecosystem. Then I will, of course, respond to the three main questions asked by organizers to us. First of all, we are SCP as a Moroccan INISO. Beyond statistics, we are making forecasting studies and planning. And we are the main player of national statistical system with many other stakeholders. That's the admin data sources and who are making, of course, some statistical surveys, and they mainly producing data for administrative purposes that we can process and use for statistical purposes. We have a strong regional representation at RCP level and for other line ministries, which are producing also statistics at regional level. I have to highlight here some background information on what we are doing regarding technology and digital transformation within RCP. We are currently implementing the digital action plan, and it's around six main areas that are to build a collaborative platform for statistical production based on GSPBM model. Then digitization of the data collection systems, of course, by using CAPI and CAWIS systems instead of PAPI, to harmonize and to improve IT tools and for statistical production from the processing to the dissemination stage. One of the most difficult projects and areas is the data management center, which is under conception and development, and it needs a lot of technical assistance from some foreign partners. Then we have the redesign of the website and the implementation of an experimental environment for the use of innovative solutions such as big data. We in general collect data from surveys, censuses, using CAPI, CATI, CAWI, and PAPI in a few statistical operations. Then we collect a lot of administrative data from line ministries. And of course, we use them for statistical purposes in national accounts and for dissemination as well. We, of course, for the user needs, we publish all what we have on our website, and we do have a statistical database, the BDS, which is, of course, give interactive access to users on the website. And of course, we have an SDP platform meant to show what are the progress on SDGs. Let me focus on how we get data from outside. So we have some free or paid access to many databases or platform, national wide. We have access via a password or via bilateral agreements with the main producers of data in Morocco. Then we have, as I said before, data coming from our surveys by different means and ways. And we have some access to some to a few registers, mainly in compiling national accounts statistics. I can see that the most, let's say, the most important or the starting point of our reflection was to design a new data management system. We did it since 3 years, even before the launch of the digital action plan. And right now we are migrating the data, all data we have from Oracle to Postgres. And we use Excel normalized templates for data entry in this first phase. But we'll shortly move to use standardized API, which is in the first version one. And of course, we are trying to use this interface of BDS to exchange data with our partners. The protocols could be various according to what are the possibilities of our data providers. We want to be flexible as much as possible in order to go and to test case by case and to be open of all what information system in our partners could be offer as a possibilities. So we can use a machine-to-machine secure protocol. We can use this DMX as we used it before for MDGs, and we have a pilot line ministry to do the exercise with it. We have an interface of BDS management system, which is used within High Commission for Planning to feed the database with statistics coming from surveys and censuses and national accounts. And as I said, yet we have yet experimented the use of SDMX with MDGs, and we will also use it for exchanging data with for SDGs. This photo shows actually how things are organized within RCP and how the feed of BDS and the data goes to the website. We have mainly four servers. The principal one is here in statistical office, because we have a lot of buildings and all the data in the different servers are synchronized in the cloud to feed at the last moment the central server, which manages also the website. Here, just screenshots from BDS, you can, and from SDG platform on the website, what we can do with this SDG platform. And concerning the link between the BDS and the SDG platform, actually we developed some technical tools which allows us to add or update an SDG indicator, and how to export indicators to JSON, then from send SDG JSON file to SDG admin. We perform those tasks in a very automatic or semi-automatic ways. Sometimes we use sending emails. Sometimes it's you use batches for performing programs, and sometimes, as I said, it's a manual task when it comes to add for the first time information about SDG indicator. Just to summarize the link between the two platforms, it is semi-automatic, if I can say, but it will be improved as soon as possible. And the best thing is that once you have indicators within BTS, you have them within a few time in SDG platform, and of course on the website short moment after this. How do we store and how do we manage data? The approach is not really different from what is existing worldwide in different organizations. We have a collection store and exploitation store and one other store for dissemination. And we have here data entries, and of course we have data to go to BDS, to the website, or to other data users. This is actually the, let's say, the global structure of the data management center we are implementing right now. We are in the phase of finalizing the conception, actually. And of course, it needs 1 year minimum to finalize the whole structure. We have to buy a server to acquire some softwares, and of course to get technical assistance to our IT department in order to finalize all the process. And the idea is to have what is coming outside the SCP or inside SCP here in the read-only store, which is, as you can see, read-only. Then we have here the exploitation store, which allows both statisticians, business intelligence specialists, data scientists to process data here, and to use information to their business lines. Then we have here a pre-dissemination store, which is the phase before this, the dissemination. And here in the pre-dissemination store, and at each level of the or at each store, we have, of course, secured accesses for administrators and for contributors to the data processing and to data dissemination. We have, of course, yet a kind of platform when we store data from previous years. So all what we have, a legacy, is stored in a kind of platform, which is now in the management and organization in order to have this more structured data sets and data files. We already prepared a catalog of all what we have, and the formats, the length, and the how many years we have the files, and from of course survey and from administrative data as well. But because we actually collect a lot of administrative data, we have a few registers, but our most aggregated statistics are coming from administrative data. The third question asked by a colleague is what we do with the governmental data platform. We have one data platform, which is for open data, governmental open data. You can see it in this link. Actually, it was built since 2004. But not regularly updated. And recently, we have set up a body which is responsible for digitalization in national ecosystem, and it's this agency who will be responsible for this platform. And yet they launched kind of a design of this platform. We contribute to, of course, as one of the main producers of data at national level. And the new functionalities are they have an API to exchange with the line ministries who have an API, and concerns mainly the open data sets. It could be also micro data coming from administrative sources. Then there is a new functionality is they provide a secured online access for all contributors, including us, to add data sets in the directly instead of sending emails and create more tasks and more work for those responsible for this platform. Then they can also, with this new design, this new platform, capture the user feedback on relevance of the data sets we publish, because the data sets should, of course, meet the user's need and not be only the data sets we want to publish on this platform. This is a screenshot from the old interface of the data platform. The new one is more convivial and more smart and more friendly, and it shows a lot of things and some statistics on the use of the new data platform. It will be launched in December, and I will later show you in another event what looks like this new data portal. What next? As I said, we have first to finalize the DMC implementation, and to do so, we have, as we are transforming our IT tools and our ways of working, our processes, it needs continuous change management activities at national level and at regional level, because we have all as well 12 offices at regional level who are providing data, making conducting surveys and collecting administrative data as well. And we have also something which is key is the API for BDS, the version 2. With it, we can be comfortable to exchange data using different means our data providers are willing to. Then we have to achieve work on standards and technical frameworks for classifications and of data exchange with the public open data platform, because it seems that in order to make the data flow very easy and very very interoperable between line ministries, we have to work, and SCP is contributing a lot in the task force for standards and references in order to share with them all what we have as standards, classifications of data, in order to make the data flow more fluent and more interoperable within the open data. Of course, we can then in this platform can have access to all data line ministries provide to the open data platform once our API will be ready. What is advised for big projects is to start with pilots, and this is what we are aiming. This is what we are actually starting to do. We're implementing automating exchange with the sub-line ministries. I can mention here the OOCP, the producer of phosphate in Morocco, one of the biggest one worldwide. To exchange aggregate data with them, then we have another pilot test with the trade statistics using ECDMX, as this our colleagues in Office of Exchange has developed the ECDMX with the USD in last year. Thank you very much for your attention. I hope that I was not as I didn't take a lot of time for organizers, and I will be happy to answer to your questions. I have to mention that maybe I'm not an IT specialist, but I hope that in the next clinics of experts for such topic, there will be other colleagues from IT department who are working with us to present things more deeply and in technical details if you hope so. Thank you very much.